A new generation of surveillance drones could soon be watching us all from overhead. The Federal Aviation Administration is expected to announce plans to expand the use of domestic drones in American airspace. Eyes in the sky, similar to the unmanned aircraft that the United States has been using to target terrorists abroad. Here at home, the surveillance systems can be used to track terrorists or drug dealers, or to find missing children, or locate wandering Alzheimer's patients. Lots of different good uses, but the critics warn the use of drones presents a major threat to all of our personal privacy. Meantime, a newly discovered Air Force intelligence document leaked and posted online states, if drones capture surveillance footage of Americans incidentally, the data can be stored and analyzed by the Pentagon for up to 90 days. And that's not all. The Fox Reports chief correspondent Jonathan Hunt is with us. When are these drones likely to be flying, and how many of them might there be above our heads?
Well, there's a growing number already, Shep, but according to the experts, and indeed the FAA itself, there could be as many as 30,000 of these kind of drones, 30,000 flying overhead within the next decade. Now, obviously, law enforcement agencies love these drones, and they say they'll be able to save lives in things like hostage situations or search and rescue operations. But obviously, the privacy concerns are huge, because they will in effect bring every single backyard in America into the authorities' view. You've always had an expectation of privacy in your own backyard. You will no longer have it with these there, and there is essentially no real legislation currently written to curtail where they can go to limit what they can see. That's the obvious concern, Chief.
The language on this document, Jonathan, incidentally getting video of Americans doing something. What does this mean?
Well, for instance, one of these drones is up, say, heading down to the U.S.-Mexico border to check out the situation there. Or it's up looking over a traffic incident in downtown Chicago. But if they're on their way flying to either of those incidents, they look down, it records in your backyard footage, say, of a whole bunch of bags of fertilizer and some tomato plants. You working on it? Are those really tomato plants? Are they marijuana plants? Are you getting that fertilizer for your garden? Or you're getting it to make bombs. They then have a reason, they say, to keep that footage, analyze it for up to 90 days, and start looking into all manner of things that you may or may not have been doing.
Is there going to be a new rule about everybody building an extra bedroom?
Yes, you cannot build an extra bedroom.
Well, I thought you were going to have to allow a member of the government to live in the house with you. No?
That may be where we're headed. The judge probably knows better than me on that.
It would probably be good for housing. Housing starts. It would be good for construction workers.
And Jerry Willis can address that one as well. We have everybody at the table here to sort out the entire situation.
A member of government for everyone and a bedroom for all. Wow, wow. It's good and great now, John.
Welcome to Monday.
Drones for all. Thanks. Well, well. Fox News senior judicial analyst Judge Andrew Napolitano is with us. They can't require us to build an extra bedroom, but I guess they can spy on us from ahead.
Well, they can't spy on us from ahead.
They really can't, can they?
No, they can't.
But they will.
Did you see any legislation enacted by the Congress or signed by the President or any amendment to the Constitution?
No.
Answer, no. These are regulations in which bureaucrats gave themselves the authority to capture images of us in the privacy of our backyards, and depending upon how low the drones fly, Jonathan can back me up, inside the home, if the drone is able to see inside the home, and to retain and analyze and distribute amongst members of the government what they find. This is not permitted by the Constitution. It's not permitted by federal law. The Congress didn't vote on it. The President's been silent about it. Bureaucrats did it on their own.
And this has been the case forever, and I know from working local television 15, 20, longer than that ago, if you, as a citizen, have a reasonable expectation of privacy, for instance, your girlfriend is laying out by the pool in the backyard and you have a 12-foot fence around your backyard. If my television camera shoots over that 12-foot fence at that woman who's naked in the backyard, I've committed a crime because she has a reasonable expectation of privacy. The drone shouldn't be allowed to do that either for the exact same reason.
I would make the same argument as your hypothetical neighbor who wants to see what your girlfriend looks like. The government would commit the crime. Shep, this is very serious. It's one thing for the government to do it. It's another thing for the Defense Department to do it. Mm. The Defense Department cannot engage in any activity in the United States of America without an executive order from the President that must be published. So if the President has authorized the Defense Department, Jonathan spoke about the Air Force, to fly drones over anybody's backyard and we don't know about it, then the President and the Air Force have violated numerous federal criminal statutes.
But nobody seems to much care.
Nobody seems to very much care. Why isn't the Congress up in arms? Same Congress that let the president bomb Libya is going to let his Air Force spy in our backyards, and like potted plants, they'll look the other way.
And there'll never be any sort of retribution for this. There'll never be anything. It's just suddenly there'll be tens of thousands of drones up in the air watching what we do. Now, if you're not doing anything, you might say, I'm not doing anything. I don't care. Well, should we just throw out the whole Constitution? Should we just run by a new set of rules? What should we do?
For Third Amendment, the Fourth Amendment, the Fifth Amendment, the Ninth Amendment were written to guarantee us the right to be left alone, meaning governments stay out of our face. We are living perfectly normal, lawful lives. We don't want you in our faces as we do it. Suddenly the government, silently from 30,000 feet above, is violating those amendments.
It is quite a thing. And it's mighty quiet.
Yes.
Judge Napolitano, thank you.
You're welcome, Shep.
Soon there will be government eyes in the skies. The Fed's considering drones to monitor everyday Americans going about their everyday lives. Fox News senior judicial analyst Judge Andrew Napolitano passed out when he heard about this. We revived him in time, gave him a new suit, and brought him in. The judge, is this even legal when you found out?
No, it's not legal. Now, we're talking about two different things. We're talking about the Air Force, which is the Department of Defense, dispatching drones to monitor people when they're outside their homes or even when they're inside their homes. We're also talking about local law enforcement, 313 of which have drones ready to be used, but the FAA has not yet authorized them to do so. So we have the Defense Department and we have local police watching us from the sky, none of which is legal without a warrant from a judge.
So President Obama didn't wake up and say, I want to see all Americans and find out what they're doing. This is something that came from the Defense Department and or the Department of Justice?
Well, the Defense Department is not permitted to do anything in the United States of America against American citizens without an executive order from the president, and he can only issue one in time of rebellion or national disaster. That's the federal law. For him to permit the Air Force to spy on us, no matter how noble their goal may be, is a violation of federal law, unless he signed an executive order and we don't know about it, in which case that would be unlawful because the executive orders of this nature have to be published.
All right, so the drones go in the skies. If a kid is missing, we already have the Amber Alert, and that's helping with street signs. What if they told you, hey, I need these drones to help find those kids?
They need a search warrant to use a drone. And if there's evidence of crime, a child kidnapped,
O.J. Simpson on the run,
a judge is more likely than not to sign a search warrant. The reason for the search warrant is the Fourth Amendment requires it, and there's a record of what they are looking for. But if they just want to dispatch drones because they have a morbid curiosity about what Americans are doing, or they don't care about our privacy, whether it's the federal government through the Air Force or whether it's local police, they don't have the authority to do so. And for Congress and the president to permit the Air Force to do this on their own, yesterday the Air Force announced a rule saying that if they're flying over Massapequa and they see Brian Kilmeade sunbathing in his backyard,
again,
they can keep the picture of you, even though they took it by accident. Let's say they're looking for something else in your neighborhood. Congress didn't do this. The president didn't do this.
Right.
The Air Force gave themselves that authority. There's no provision anywhere for them to give themselves that authority.
All right. And when do you think I'm going to find this time to sunbathe? I'm very curious.
I don't know.
Thank you.
With your schedule.
Now, I listened to Charles Krauthammer last night and Democrats, too. There seems to be bipartisan outrage from this, about this. Do you think this is one time where both sides will come together?
Well, I would hope so. I mean, when the president bombed Libya, the Congress looked the other way. Now the president wants to dispatch plastic drones to spy on Americans, it would be reprehensible for the Congress to look the other way. And I want to give a shout out to Charles Krauthammer. He's 100% correct. The first American patriot that shoots down one of these drones that comes too close to his children in his backyard will be an American hero.
But I'm just going to give you another scenario. Lackawanna 6, training in Buffalo. They think there's something going on there. They can't get in, but they can see above. Would you say it's okay to use a drone for that?
Get a search warrant from a judge. That's what the Constitution says.
All right. We'll find out if a drone's coming to a neighborhood near you and if my sunbathing pictures will be public and if I will have some control.
Do those pictures exist?
I will not answer that question, and you cannot make me unless I see my attorney.
I'm your attorney.
Investigating the investigations, the FBI launching a probe into J.P. Morgan's huge trading blunder. Now the judge is asking, Why is the government investigating a bad investment? That is a brilliant question.
Well, I ask that question, Neil, because J.P. Morgan Chase did not bet with its customers' money. It did not bet with taxpayers' money. It bet with its own money. And since when is the government in the business of saving us from the consequences of our own bad judgment? Charlie Gasparino informs us that this is just a small fraction of the money they bet and an infinitesimal fraction of the money that they will earn.
Yeah, he says, what, they're going to make $16 billion?
You know, the other side of this is they lost $2 billion. They didn't put it in a fireplace and burn it. They lost it in what seemed to be prudent gambles. Someone or some group earned $2 billion at the same time. So good for them. Why aren't we celebrating that triumph rather than J.P. Morgan's loss?
Yeah, in the scheme of things, they're still up. In the scheme of things, the government is still down.
The reason we are bemoaning J.P. Morgan Chase is because they are a target. They are a target of this president and his big government allies who would like to use this loss of their own money as a means to regulate them even further, which means banks will do less, will be less risky, will earn less, and will charge their customers more.
Our mutual friend Charlie Gasparino had said, maybe this is an argument for breaking up big banks, that you can get too big.
I hesitate to disagree with him. As you know, he's the triumvirate of Cavuto, Gasparino, Napolitano in this building. But what business is it of the government to break up a bank because the bank loses its own money? This is behavior that shouldn't even
be regulated. No, I agree with you, but here's the argument for it, that when it feeds on itself and there's a great meltdown of losses accompanied with it, and the stocks of all these institutions, which is a lot of their worth, also go south. We all pay for that.
That's because of that socialist entity called the Federal Deposit Insurance Corporation, where the federal government basically insures the depositors.
You'd let them go?
Well, if you want to use the fact that the feds, meaning taxpayers, will ultimately bear the cost of this as a means to regulate it, then by that logic, the feds could regulate anything. Look, the FBI does not start criminal investigations within 4 days of the revelation of the crime. The documents, and there are hundreds of thousands of them in this case, are still in London. They're still in J.P. Morgan Chase's hands. So the fact that this investigation has started is a belief. It's not a certainty. The government has far more crucial cases online ahead of itself than this one. But the reason we're talking about it is because the president wants to pick on this bank.
And make it an issue.
In this
and
election.
A deflection.
In this election campaign.
Judge, thank you very, very much. Judge Napolitano.
And President Obama's campaign managers now banning cell phones at all private fundraising events. They say they're trying to prevent people from taking potentially embarrassing photos or videos. Brian?
All right, Gretch, a wounded veteran pulled over by police, then handcuffed and thrown in jail. Why? Well, cops found and confiscated some unregistered guns. But when prosecutors dropped the charges, the cops kept the guns? Judge Andrew Napolitano, can they do that, Judge?
Unfortunately, they can, Brian. I mean, this is an unusual quirk in the law. These guns were lawfully registered and lawfully owned and being lawfully transported by this vet. But because he came to a complete stop, other than a traffic stop, in Washington, D.C., he actually stopped to go to Walter Reed Hospital for a medical checkup. Once he was there and the car stopped, he had an obligation under the law. I don't agree with the law, but this is what it is, to comply with the gun laws of the place where he stopped. And because they weren't registered in D.C., they could be confiscated and he could be charged. So far, that's the law. They filed charges against him, unlawful possession of the guns. He pleaded guilty. They eventually rescinded the guilty plea and dropped the charges. Then he says, okay, let me have my guns back. And the police say, no, we're going to keep them. This is a dirty little secret. When the police confiscate guns, they very, very, very rarely give them back, even when you are the lawful owner.
And, do the individual cops have these guns, or do they go into a bin for general law enforcement?
The cops use guns when they confiscate them, and that itself is unlawful because the gun is not registered to the governmental entity that owns them. I don't know if that's happening in this case, but I know of examples in which I was personally involved when I was on the bench when these things happen. The guns are probably no longer in the possession of the police department. They are somewhere in law enforcement being used and cannot be traced back to law enforcement.
So he's going state to state, and he gets stops in D.C. to go to Walter Reed. They thought he had a suspended license. He did. didn't. It was a mistake on North Carolina's part. He goes and straightens that out. They check his car. They find the guns. They throw him in jail. They won't give him a blanket. They were sarcastic. He said, we treated Afghan detainees in Afghanistan better than he was treated in Washington.
Another dirty little secret of law enforcement is that frequently when you are arrested for something like this and you're not in a prison with major facilities, you're in a holding cell, you're going to be treated as you would not expect to be treated. You're innocent until proven guilty at that point. He should be respected whether he's a veteran or not.
Here's what the Metropolitan Police told us. We've identified mistakes in reference to this case. We are working to resolve this matter quickly. My hunch is, Judge, that perhaps they're going to get the guns back.
It'd be very nice. You know, I had a similar case like this. I ordered the guns returned. The appellate court upheld me. The Supreme Court reversed us and said the police can keep the guns.
Right.
You're not bitter. No, I'm not bitter. I'm furious. Yeah, it was 15 years ago.
All right, Judge. Thanks so much. And hopefully the people would understand when you serve our country, you do deserve a second look and would be treated a little bit better, even if you do have something that turns out to be incorrect, and that was a suspended license.